We had taken the approach here at the Odette Cancer Centre to use radiosurgery alone for several years now. We've really believed in this approach. We've used whole brain radiation sparingly, more as a last resort type of therapy for when we can't use focused radiation because there are too many spots that have arisen. And in order to validate that practice, we asked some of the leading authors of the randomized studies around the world to give their individual patient data to us. And together with some statisticians and McMaster, we put the entire cohort or group of patients together and looked at what the effects were of just focused radiosurgery as opposed to whole brain radiation plus radiosurgery. And what we found was that patients who were treated with just radiosurgery did better than if you were given whole brain radiation plus radiosurgery with respect to survival. Patients who were 50 years and younger really had that survival benefit. Otherwise, for older patients, there was no disadvantage. And it's not just survival, but patients' quality of life, so their ability to lead their normal lives with less fatigue, appetite loss, or better mood. That's all better with just focused radiation as opposed to whole brain radiation. Now, it's hypothesis generating, meaning that we further have to understand why we're seeing this effect, but it is a very interesting and provocative result that is going to impact practice in the sense that more people would be inclined to use just radiosurgery or focused radiation approach, at least for patients who are 50 years and younger, who present with one, two, or up to four tumors, as opposed to adding on whole brain radiation. And this practice is currently being endorsed by some of our major institutions, like the American Society of Therapeutic Radiation Oncology, who recently came out and said that if you're going to treat with focused radiation, don't add the whole brain radiation after. So if you can, treat with focused radiosurgery, save the whole brain radiation for later. There are obvious benefits that have been proven in studies with respect to quality of life and memory functioning, and now we've shown some data to say that you may actually live longer, especially for patients who are 50 years and younger.